So here's how crazy things have gotten here at the National Academy of Sciences. We want to test this idea that many of you bring into this room tonight, this idea that there is value in an integrated educational experience in science, humanities, and art in a way, and you see it up there, STEAM, in a way that will add value to the experiences of undergraduates and graduate students and K-12 students in ways that make them better educated and better prepared for the workforce of the 21st century. That's kind of our hypothesis, that this STEAM idea adds value to their educational and workforce readiness experience. And so we're ready. Can I help you, sir?
Sorry.
Yeah.
A lot more crowded than I thought.
There's a seat right here.
Sure, sorry.
Are you here for the STEM to STEAM?
Yeah, all right.
Right
here? All right, cool.
Is that
thanks.
Good?
Yeah, no worries.
So we're talking about STEM to STEAM and the value to science of integrated educational experience.
All right.
You seem skeptical.
Well, I mean, I'm a scientist, so I like numbers and equations.
You're a scientist.
So.
I'm Tom.
I am. I'm Tom, too. Nice to meet you.
Okay, I'll remember that. Yeah. Come on up for a second. Come on up.
Like up in front of everyone?
Yeah, in front of everybody.
Sure. Okay.
So we're here talking about the value of arts and humanities and science in an integrated experience. What do you think of that?
Okay, sure, maybe. I'm skeptical.
What kind
I'm
of skeptical. Scientist are you?
I'm a meteorologist.
Meteorologist,
yep.
Very good.
Yep.
It's great to meet a scientist who gets it right about half the time, okay? So, why are you skeptical of this?
Well, you know, I'd learned science. We did a lot of equations. I remember a lot of times in school worrying about equations, not so much
It's all about the data, right?
It's all about the data.
Yeah, I get that. That's really what it is about in this building and in the work we do. I mean, I'm not a scientist. I have to come in the side door. They don't let me in the front door. But I know all about the data.
Okay.
But I'm going to flip ahead for a second here.
Ready?
You're a meteorologist.
Yeah? Oh.
Check that out, by the way. I'm flipping ahead here. What do you see, Mr. Meteorologist?
Those are clouds.
What kind of clouds?
They're beautiful. They look like they're cumulus clouds developing over the ocean.
So, as I said, I'm not a scientist. I'm going to ask you kind of a dumb question, and I apologize to my Academy's colleagues here for making us all look stupid. What's a cloud, for crying out loud? What is a cloud?
It's water. Cloud's water. You know how... Like right now, we're all breathing in water. There's water in the air, it's gas, but a cloud, as you can see, it's liquid water, but really, really tiny microscopic droplets that just kind of suspend.
And the water just defies gravity, it just stays up there.
It's so small. Like ever see like a ray of light and like see like a speck of dust kind of like lingering? Or I ever see like the end of the movie Forrest Gump, where like the feather just keeps going like that with the beautiful music, you know?
So the water just stays up there.
Yeah. Water just
and then did they, like, when did they decide, like, did they say, oh, there's a Nationals game coming up, let's start dumping on the Nationals game. When does it decide to rain?
Well, I'm a Mets fan, I just want to get out there right now. So basically when the air rises, it cools and it knocks all these droplets together. So they get bigger and bigger and bigger, and then it gets so heavy they'll end up falling, and it ends up falling like rain.
Yeah, I like the way, I can get it when you describe it. I love the motion, I love the movement. Very good.
I'm Italian,
here's my next question. What's wind? What is wind? I feel it, but I don't see it. What is wind?
Wind is it's air blowing around. So like
air blowing around.
It's air blowing around. Like you guys are feeling wind right now, because I'm moving air around to you guys. So Earth is always wants to be at like an equal level, but like the poles are a lot colder than the tropics. So the tropics, the air rises and eventually falls down somewhere else, but air has to kind of replace it. So that replacing of air moving all the way around is just just wind.
The way you describe that, and I like the way even the historian and I can get it when you describe it that way. So, but let me ask you one other thing about this. I'm going to jump ahead to
There's more.
One of these things. Could someone cue this up?
Like a pop quiz?
You gotta be patient now. Anyone recognize this person? Yeah.
Thank you.
You gotta wait for it, Tom.
Okay.
You gotta wait for it.
All right.
What that remind you?
It reminds me of a thunderstorm. It reminds me of thunder.
Why?
Well, it's this build up. You see a little bit of rain, and then you see this kind of build up, and all this big roar and this big rumble of thunder.
Yeah.
All this kind of like violent action.
So what's going on in what happens in a thunderstorm?
A thunderstorm. Well, you need lightning first before you can have thunder. Lightning is the light. Light moves faster than sound. So you see the lightning before you hear the thunder.
Right,
and what's going
on? You count so many, I guess.
Exactly,
that, yeah.
Seven, whatever it is, and it's a kilometer. But don't be outside during a lightning storm, it's not good. And basically what happens is, like, lightning's really, really hot. So when it moves from the cloud to the ground, it expands the air around it and creates a sound wave.
Okay.
So that's what you're hearing, but like lightning is the light, is like the older brother, and the sound is like the younger brother kind of running after it.
Got it. I love the way you describe that. So, ladies and gentlemen, will you join my co-conspirator? Join me in thanking my co-conspirator, Tom. Thank you very much.
But now I seriously have to find a seat.
So I love the precision of the meteorologist. Oh, it's around 7 seconds or so, whatever it is. But so look, we wanted to have a little fun, and we wanted to illustrate what you all already know, and that is that, and we did it in kind of a simplified way. But let me ask you, what elements of art and humanities and science did you see in the last 3 or 4 minutes that maybe helped explain this notion of what is weather, what is meteorology? Share with me what you saw or heard, or what elements of history, literature, linguistics, art in its many forms did you hear and see? Yes. Metaphor, what was the example? You had a lot, yeah. Great. What other art? Yes, sir. Movement. Yeah, dance. Right. Yeah. My daughter took modern dance, and I was like, is that really dance? But I got it after about the fifth recital. So what else? What else? Yes, please.
Music.
Right. Tell the story. It all told a story. Anything else? I mean, we saw it all. We saw history. We saw culture. We saw art, fine art. We saw theater, I mean drama. We tried to bring it to life. And so that's the idea here. That's the first idea, which is, can we, yes, did you saw something? Attempts to understand things, exactly. That's the point, is you all observed what most of us in the room value, and that is ways to engage, ways to bring life to the curriculum, to the experience. Those are very cool things and seem to add great value to the educational experience. So that's kind of what we're going to try to do with our National Academies project that we just received a huge grant from the Mellon Foundation for yesterday, a $750,000 grant to launch a 2-year study of this question. And every word in this question matters. Where is the evidence that there is value in an integrated educational experience in STEM, arts, and humanities? And the key to this whole thing, because how many people here think, you can raise your hand if you want to, how many people think it's kind of cool to teach and instruct this way? Yeah, it is kind of cool. And how many people suspect that there's value to the student and to our society? Yeah, we all suspect that. That's our hypothesis, that there is value. What there isn't much of yet is solid evidence that there is value to this kind of educational experience in an integrated way. What do we mean by evidence? I have my little, they don't make us wear these things all the time. I'll pass them around. This is kind of our little, there you go. You'll see it eventually. Can't see it from up here. Where's the evidence that there's value to this? When, at what point can we make a case, go to Congress with this report, or go to a governor, or go to a policymaker at any level, and say there's value in investing in the arts and the humanities, and in science, of course, and the value comes in terms of the educational outcomes of the students that we all want to serve, and their readiness for a changing workforce. And you, I think, illustrated very well how this conversation has been happening. What we need is to say to Congress, here's the evidence, and here's the return on investment you are likely to get, if we can find the evidence, if we can assemble it. And so I'll conclude with this point, really. As we undertake this project, I hope we can stay in touch with most of you who are interested in it. If you have evidence, we need to see it. We want to see it. And, you know, some evidence, I suppose, is it feels good, it's cool, it sounds great, my kids are engaged. But we also are looking for evidence of, and I had a department chair from mechanical engineering at Lafayette College say to me, I was talking to her not about this project, but actually about mechanical engineering. And I said, what's the number one skill that an ME needs to be successful in the workforce? And she said, empathy. And I'm like, huh? What? Yeah. If you don't know who you're building your machine for, then how are you going to build the best machine? And so that's what we're hoping to do over the next 2 years with this big Mellon grant and maybe a little more money and maybe a lot of ideas from you. And that is try to determine the evidence behind, the data behind, the narrative behind this idea that there's value in an educational experience that integrates these disciplines, does it in an effective way, and adds great value to the experience of the students and the institutions they attend and ultimately our society as a whole. So stay tuned, become part of the project if you will, and we'll see what we get at the end of a couple years. If we conclude that there is no evidence, then I saw the hot dog stand in front of the metro station, and I'll be working there. Thank you so much.